Turning on Facebook Live because people are going to expect something.
Okay. And so I think probably today we should just bullshit.
Careful. Facebook Live is on.
Awesome. I should be careful with that.
Not that we care.
Hi, Facebook Live. So what are they seeing? They're seeing what you're seeing.
They're only seeing my camera because if I switch it, then it screws you up.
That's all right. You know, but probably at some point they should probably see me. But I get it. I get it.
Yeah, because I don't have my camera for the over the shoulder shot because it's still packed up.
But got it. Okay,
I've got this shot, and this is David here. It's just black.
Oh, got it.
So you guys on Facebook Live, we're testing David's studio, and he's unable to transmit to Facebook Live and do all the rest of the stuff. So I am doing that, but if I switch my camera, it screws him up. So you can hear him. But
and I wonder, could I send you the over the shoulder? Let's see. If I send you.
There's.
No, it's this
now
one.
Now we're going to have a hall of mirrors.
No, that's okay. Right here. If I send you this one and I go there. Now you show it. Show your face. Now, what do you see?
I see your over the shoulder shot and my face on your screen.
And your face. All right. We've made it happen.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I can see it down in my corner here. So we're making progress here. So I'm going to switch out of this shortly. Oh, actually, no, I have shortcuts. So I have an open, so I can do that.
Yeah, but it should be over a picture.
Yeah, I have to figure out what picture. I should just be over the live picture.
Yeah, right? Well, your face, usually.
Nobody wants to see my face.
If you're going to host the show, I mean...
I was kidding.
I will grant you that Bert, K1OIK, doesn't want to see either one of us, although he'll probably, to spite me, say that he wants to see you.
Right.
Which is fine.
He's that troll du jour.
He's my perma-troll.
Got it. All right. Is anything coming from this camera? No.
I saw you in the corner for a moment.
So there's this camera, the over-the-shoulder shot.
Yeah.
So I could open... And thank you, Facebook, for sticking with us here and our audience.
Oh, they're in for the ride, and this
awesome.
Is all just this is not going to be show quality. You're sitting on top of the title.
Yeah, that's
you're layering.
So I'm reordering. So this is how the open should look.
Yeah.
And I don't know if we heard sound or not. It looked like I'm going to do that one more time. It looks like I see sound on my sound bar here, and it's all washed out, like you said. So there's the open. I can do that. Awesome. And. Then I can do title, and then you can see me and my new, wonderful, awesome lighting. Thank you, Marty, for helping with that. And I will tell you, I did that lighting for 12, 24, 30, $42.
Pretty good. I did my lighting for $800.
Yeah, $42 right now. I'm into that lighting. And actually, I think just looking at this shot right now, I'm so happy that my forehead isn't shiny. Or there's a little bit of shiny, but I think it's because it's warm in here. But I've been shiny forehead for a long time, and I think that color-wise, this is probably the first time you actually saw my real-ish color. And a lot less neck than I had before, too. All right, and...
Yeah, you don't look all that pink.
Yeah, well, I think part of the losing 20 pounds is pink and less neck.
We're going to have to tell people how you did that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
So you want to introduce this show?
We should do that. So the show title. So episode number 346, messed up on the numbering, yeah, West Coast Studio Bull Session.
Pay no attention to the actual number on the title.
Yeah, don't pay attention to the number. And you know, the stupid thing is I sat there looking at their show when I made this up so that I could get everything. So critique me. I know that I'm not exactly the right font, but this doesn't look too bad, right?
You should use a bold font.
A bold font, okay. Yeah.
So it thickens it up. And that's about
bold
it.
Font. Yeah. I'm writing my...
I use Arial bold.
Bold font, okay. I'm writing notes.
Yeah, I use exciting Arial.
Ooh. Yeah. Trendsetter.
As boring as it gets.
Woohoo! That's all right. So, I've got that, and we introduced the show. And then probably the next thing we say is if you like us and you want to support us, then... And I don't know, can anybody see this, Gary?
I see it.
Cool. You should contribute. So click on go to hamradionow.tv and click on contribute and feed the pig, whether you use Patreon or one-time PayPal or just send Gary a check.
Yeah. Or you could send David a check. He's good on QRZ.
I am good on QRZ. And then let's see what other so I got that. I've got this, and I need to change that camera, but I'll work on that for later. I got the over-shoulder shot. Please do not pay attention to the mess in the background. That will go away.
Everybody do screen captures and put them on your Facebook pages.
Absolutely. Put that on there. That'll be my new Facebook. It's just a box of camping gear. Whatever. And let's see, what else do I got? I got this one. That was a fail. And that's a fail. I got our webpage for the YouTube videos. And I tried to start with the landing page, but I couldn't get it so that the landing page didn't just play your Patreon pitch every time.
Yeah.
So
I don't know why. They used to have it so that if you were subscribed to the page,
it
wouldn't play.
But... Well, you know, I know why that is. It's because this is opening it in the OBS browser, and the OBS browser is dumb as tree bark. No offense, OBS people. And so it doesn't have that flag marked. Because it's funny, when I go on my local PC to the page that I bookmarked, it doesn't do that Patreon thing. But when I put the URL in the setup, it played it every time. So I couldn't fix that.
If you go there, you should be able to stop it pretty quick.
No, that's the other thing. So here, what you see on the screen, if you can see the screen, I can't pretty much do anything but show you the screen.
You're going to make all the OBS. Well, I guess we should explain what OBS is.
Yes.
And then you're going to make all the OBS fanboys mad.
Well, you know what? Somebody call me and tell me, help me. Oops, that didn't work. Oh, there you go. So I made it full screen. That didn't quite work. Yeah, somebody help me. Marty was helpful. Actually, that was a good start, and now I got more to do. So let's see. We showed the title page. We showed the Gary page. We showed the open fly-in. We saw ARVN. Oh, and I got the close, but we're not ready to close yet, so I shouldn't show that. So that's where I'm at.
We need Jerry and Amy to help us close the show.
Yeah. That was, you know what? I actually, you were right. I was jealous, and that was an awesome show, no matter what the guys on QRZ said.
Do you have a split screen yet?
A split screen?
Yeah. Show us both at the same time.
Well, I haven't figured that one out yet.
It looks like this.
So what should I show? Okay, so let's build that. Well, you keep talking while I build it.
I'm tired.
You're tired?
I've been on the road. I've been on the road for like a month.
Yeah, you have.
Started with going out to Wyoming for the eclipse, which was awesome.
Yep.
And then...
That was a good show.
The Bike MS event, which was fun. And then... Hawaii, and literally the day after getting back from Hawaii, getting on the road to St. Louis for the DCC. So I'm worn out, and that's why you all haven't seen very many shows, because I haven't been here to make them.
Yeah, and I tried, and then we got to 400 degrees in the garage, because we had, actually it was like 118 or 120 outside. And I just couldn't take being in here. And so I, all right. So if you put yourself up and can you put you up, Gary, in Skype? Oh, we have Hall of Mirrors.
Oh, yeah. I'm supposed to show you. Well, I was showing the Facebook audience. I have someone to introduce to you.
A newbie.
Yes, it is our newest acquisition and yet another tuxedo blind cat. So, or blind tuxedo cat. And this is Washi, little Washi kitten, little full of energy, bundle of energy kitten. And we fostered her for a couple of weeks. We needed to get her up to 3 pounds so that she could be spayed. So we did that. And that was before we went to Hawaii. And then we took her, well, we got her up to 3 pounds. We took her back to the shelter, and we said, she is just absolutely lovable. You know, she just getting your arms and purr.
What does everybody else think about her?
So we told the shelter we would adopt her, although four cats was usually our ceiling, and we've got four. But we fell in love with her, of course. And we told the shelter that if they put her out for adoption and nobody picked her up in the couple of weeks that we'd be gone, that we would take her full time.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's all we had to say.
That's all you had to say. They're like, oh, we'll just keep them from the Pearsa, for the Pearsa when they come back.
Yeah.
All right, I have split screen set up.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Here's Washi.
You can, there, awesome.
Could still feel the stitches from her operation.
For the spaying part. Yeah. So when they come blind, do they have to, I guess it depends on what their blindness is all about, right?
Yeah, she didn't have any eyeballs when she was born.
Got it.
Which has been the case for all the cats except for the bear. The bear, it was bear day that just the other day. It was 1 year since we let the bear go, which, of course, happened when I was at the DCC last year. So he had vision when he was born, and he was just abused. He got some infection, and whoever had him at the time didn't take him to the vet and get it handled. So by the time he did get to a vet, it was too late. So everybody else, we had a cat named Rennie who I had just giant black eyes, and he had no retinas in his eyes. There's nothing in the back, but he had eyes. Everyone else had no eyeballs to speak of. And we'll have a surgeon do a little surgery. There's, you know, sort of a residual of eyeballs in here. We'll have a surgeon do some surgery and remove them. And that eliminates the possibility for infection, or at least reduces it. So right now, if you could, and I don't really have a shot that would get you there.
Look, yummy finger.
Yeah. Daddy tastes good. You could see a little glint, but it's not really eyeballs. It's just sort of an extra lid.
Yeah.
So we'll get those removed, and they stuff a little cotton in there to keep it keep it from becoming a depressed area, you know, hollow out. And
how are the other four making along with?
We're just starting to introduce them.
Oh, got it.
And there's a little hissing. There usually is.
Yeah.
But they're starting to get used to it, and we do this very slowly over the course of a few weeks.
Yeah.
Most of the time, it works out okay.
That's what we've done when we brought other cats in. Are all four blind?
No, two striped cats are blind, and then normally we don't take cats that have all working parts. The other two cats are Ginger, and they physically they're pretty much fine, but emotionally they're basket cases.
Okay.
And they came to us much worse than they are now. They're coming along. So we considered them to be special needs just because of their psychology. So
got it.
Five kitty cats. The two Gingers are kind of old. We have no idea how old, but they're probably pushing 10. So they got a few more years. We'll see what happens. Go ahead. The guys on Facebook are pretty cool about this. It's the guys on QRZ.com that complain that we're talking about cats and not ham radio.
Yeah, I'm not sure this is going to be a QRZ-worthy episode. But
we probably won't put it up there.
I
think I'm pretty much done with QRZ.
Yeah.
The comments that folks made on the episode with Amy and Jerry are just unwarranted.
Yeah. I went in there and looked, and there were some, you know, folks that, oh, look, I got
click the page.
Lord, there we go. There were some folks in there, and it looked like it was more like 80-20 rule. I think about 80% of everybody thought it was great and thought all the trolls were trolls.
Maybe I just paid too much attention to them.
Yeah. Well, and that's the hard part. You know, all it takes is one jerk out of 100. Or five jerks out of 20 or whatever.
Yeah. And then after a bit, it goes on to those guys making their own show that has nothing to do with the show that
right
it started as.
Yep. So. Yep. Absolutely. Absolutely.
On
All right.
By about the fourth frame of comments, that any relation to the original post is pretty much gone.
Yeah, it's pretty much gone. So what I can tell from the two of us sitting next to each other here, and I don't know, can you send the what I'm sending you back to Facebook?
I can send it out to Facebook.
You pick me, right?
Yeah, I can send it out to Facebook, but it's going to, in a moment, it'll be the Hall of Mirrors.
Got it. Right, because you're on the other side there.
Yeah, this may work a little better. There'll be a Hall of Mirrors, but it'll be so tiny that folks can't really see it.
Yeah. All right, I'll have to remember that. There's the other shot. So the two of us together, so now I'm better colored, but I guess it's too bright, and I don't know if I can control the camera with everything going on right now to pull the gain down. But I think I got the autofocus off. Yeah, no, I guess it's still doing the adjustment.
Yeah. I may be a little dark. These programs don't give us as much control over the shots as we like, although the newer versions of Wirecast at least finally have what we in the television business called a proc amp, or processing amplifier, which gives basic control of brightness, contrast, hue.
No, that's not me. Where am I? Where did I go? Oh, I'm on the title one. There you go. That'll keep us from going. If you put me up next to you, that'll keep us from going in your split screen. So I have to figure out how to do this split screen without it going. There you go. So you're showing you and Skype, or you're showing you and...
Me and Skype. Me on, right. On this screen, and then over there is
it's Skype.
Would be so cool if a finger could appear.
Right. So when I do this Skype, which I'll kill it, I'll switch it back in a minute. It's... Who's here? It's me and Skype.
Yeah.
I'll put it back to lower title.
Oops. I keep forgetting how I have to switch. You really don't want a television studio on each end.
I totally get it. I won't. I promise. For now, until I get 100% ready to do this, and I'm gonna do what I did the other day as a test. Is I have the camera here, and I have the camera here, and I did one of those. Hi, I'm here, and then I switched it. Oh, and now I'm back over here. Just to test to see if I could make it work. And this one was the other one over there was on a different PC. So I had Skype going back and forth, which is how I worked through most of the challenges I've had. Before I think I should actually do a show, then I need to have that and send you it. And you can look at it and make sure, yeah, you think it's bad enough that we're not going to lose too many guests or too many audience members.
Have you seen the other shows?
I have seen some of the other shows. I listen more than I watch, because mostly I car it, but our shows I always watch.
Yeah, I think someone's trying to dial in. I don't know if they're trying to dial you or dial me.
I didn't see. Oh, wait, I saw something here. Who is it?
I'm hearing plink plink.
Ad? No. I have a little pop-up one underneath. How do I see who it is?
Yeah, it does. I don't think they're trying to call me. I think they're trying to call you.
Shoot.
And we don't know who it is, so you're taking a risk.
Yeah. Oh, and I'm not going to bring him in. Well, unless I see it pop up. Let's see. View my sidebar. Nope. Hi, Cindy.
Cindy, you're on TV. Barely. She's in her pajamas. Doesn't want to.
Oh, you called. Oh yeah, that's all I see here is you called.
I didn't just call.
No, you called before, so I must not have been on my side.
Well,
I don't know.
Oh, maybe it was Marty.
I should go on this side.
If Marty, if that's you out there, you should call David, not me, because.
No, he should call you. No, you're hosting the show.
Well. I'm hosting the Facebook side of the show.
Oh, you're hosting the Facebook. Oh, well, you know, then I totally messed this up, because I haven't ever hit record. It'll be in Facebook. It'll be saved there.
You can pull it back from Facebook.
Right. It'll all be Facebook. Hi, Marty.
Am I making it in?
We got
sound.
But you're not video. There you are.
Got picture.
There I am.
Hold your phone sideways. There you go.
One second. There we go. I'm in the... I'm in the phasing line studio in the middle of the build out here, so have yet to get a camera set up.
Oh, all right. Well, you'll get there.
Phasing line is going to become a television show.
Let me turn the camera around. Okay. So here's the room in the middle of emptying it out. Let me go to the wide shot here. My cameraman has yet to get the switcher set up. Let's see. So it is, let's see. I can't see the shot, so I can't
see it. I see a sofa. I see is that Billy an exercise Bass on the
wall bike. Let's see. There we go.
Oh, no. There you go.
So it's I'm in the middle of cleaning out. It is 10 by 17.
And is this the basement?
It's the first floor.
First floor, all right.
And we're going to make some. And a pile of C-stands over there. And some
lost your picture.
I know. There we go. Live from the basement of Sully Productions.
Woohoo!
Am I crooked? Am I?
You are now.
There I go.
Well, and so if you didn't see before, Marty, I'll flip you around. And here's the $42 lighting stuff.
What did you end up going with?
Exactly what you told me to do. I got the little can, you know, aluminum can lights, and I went to Home Depot and I got two 5,500 LEDs and some of that diffusing fabric, and it's on a ladder.
It looks good.
Yeah. A much better color now.
Obviously the color sucks on this thing, but that's how it goes.
Yeah. Well, that's right.
We got, I have 1x1 light LED panels here, so those are actually real lights. They'll look nice.
So and we're going to make, what did I do?
There's Gary. You're sharing the split.
Yeah. I thought I had a shot that was just
you and me. You had one that was just
am I calling me. Am I calling David or am I calling Gary?
No, you called Gary.
Yeah, but I called you back cuz
we have too many people who want to switch video right now.
Right.
Right. And I stopped switching video. I'm not doing that anymore.
So let's see the overhead shot.
Oh, the over the shoulder shot?
Yeah.
I need to work on the over the shoulder shot.
Yeah, I really do.
I have to do away with that. Actually, what's nice about
it either needs to be higher over the shoulder and pointing in the right direction. Yeah. Or it needs to be an overhead shot.
Well, and what I'm gonna do is I have another monitor which is on the wrong table right now, so the other monitor will be here, and I'll put that on the tripod so it's a little higher up. You can see you'll see the bald spot, but that's okay.
Is the idea that it's pointing at a monitor or is it a gadget cam?
Oh, I haven't decided that yet.
Because if you're trying to do like a gadget cam, put it on a really high overhead rig.
Or put right, it on your mic. Put it on your microphone.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could put it here.
But what we always do at work is we use a C-stand over the guy's head.
Works got it. Just, Newegg had these Logitech cameras on sale for like $39, $49.
They're like decent. I found they work only when you have plenty of light and the color on them sucks and they're kind of soft. But they're a great value.
I think for what I'm going to do for now. I mean, this works pretty good. And I have all these scenes. I got the closing. I got Arvin. I got flying stuff. There's
so what are you doing? Are you just keying it out?
Yeah, I'm just going through the scene selector. And I have hotkeys for them. But
right,
I have
are you using for key for the lower thirds? Are you using are you chroma keying them or how are you keying them in?
It's all through OBS. So I've set up a scene for each one.
I understand that. My question is to overlay the graphics.
Yeah.
It would be what you call an alpha key.
It's an alpha key. Okay.
Okay.
Now you're speaking my language.
All right. I have no idea what either of you are talking about, but that's what I'm doing.
So if you have an alpha channel, okay, I shouldn't bother explaining.
Well,
I'll
look it up later on.
The title that you've got at the bottom there, the Ham Radio Now West Coast Studio,
yep,
is a frame of picture. And,
right.
And behind the title is black.
Right.
So why isn't the screen black? Because it is also sending to OBS a cutout signal, a black and white cutout signal that tells OBS where you see the white, show this title. Where you don't see it, show another scene.
So what I so when I do real stuff, or not real stuff for work, when we do live streaming, you know, out of the computer that has the graphics, there's the there's two channels that come out, right? And then we feed that into the switcher, and the switcher knows what to do with it.
Yeah, no, I'm not that fancy yet.
Yeah.
Well, in programs like Wirecast and OBS, all that happens in the background. You don't You don't do anything to make it work other than send it an image that it can deal with.
Right.
A PNG file will do that. A JPEG file will not.
Will not. You'll see the background. What are you doing for the what are you doing for the live graphics?
For the live stuff, the only stuff I have live right now, there's the open, and Gary sent me the movie file, and that's sitting on top. It's the same thing. It's that same frame on top of. The close is not live. In OBS, so like I have like the YouTube page up here, so OBS will just show me the page. If it has an active thing, it'll activate right on its own. Otherwise, it's not interactive. And I played around with a couple different pages.
Hey, you know, we haven't had the chance to say congratulations, Marty. Way to go.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, thank you, Gary.
Oops, I'll promote Marty to full screen. Yeah.
Here I go.
Marty
he's Chief Troublemaker.
Young Ham of the Year, he is. He's the Yoda Ham.
Yeah. But it's a longer title than that, and I'm sure I will not get it right.
Newsline Bill Pasternak Memorial Young Ham of the Year, et cetera, et cetera.
Right. Yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
I can't think of more than 30 or 40 other people that deserve it more.
Well, aren't you lovely? Charming, you know, very modest.
That's my job. Gary. That's my job. Good at it.
That's his job. Yeah, so I guess we're both building out studios. So there's a pair of... I have four cameras. I need to sell a camera. Two Vixia G40s and a Blackmagic studio camera.
I normally have six cameras going.
Okay, so tell me. So I've got two. What am I? Or actually, I have a third. I haven't plugged it in. So I need to have. So there's this one. That's the money shot, right?
You have the close up. You don't have a wide shot, right?
This is the shot that Bert will complain about because it's got you on it.
You're right. Exactly. I did an interview
with Bert last week because he bumped into me at some convention. I'm a contester, so I don't think I'm ever going to see that published on the internet.
So I know for this shot, I'm going to put another monitor here. And actually, I have what I thought I was going to do, and I didn't get there, is I have a 32-inch monitor, and I thought maybe I'd put it here, and that's where I'd put the, you know, Gary or you or whoever the guest is.
With these cameras, you're probably gonna have to stop it way down to see the monitor.
It's possible.
Well, you actually, the thing to do is make the monitor dim, because if you look at the monitors that I've got here, if you were to be here in the room, you would say, well, they're not very bright.
Got it.
Right. So
if you were to look at me, you would say, well, he's not very bright either.
Yes. Well, you're not a bright. No, well, that's true.
You almost got one. Got a zinger in there.
No. So I'm bringing the dim down a little bit here.
Yeah, that helps.
So what I was thinking was, if I can work it out, I'm going to try that 32-inch there, and then I'll move this one over a little bit more. So that's the over the shot. And actually, I do have one more that's not plugged in, and I guess I could put that on the mic for the close-up. What's the other three cameras for, Gary?
So. Let me tell you what I do, and then Gary can tell you what he
does.
So if you have, say, four cameras, what I would do is I'd do a wide shot.
Right.
Gary, switch to your wide shot. You know, show and tell. Then wide shot.
Well, I don't have all four cameras set up again yet. They're still in
the
boxes.
Yeah, there's the big over the shoulder.
Yeah.
Right. So I need to go out more with the over the shoulder camera.
Well, it depends what you want. You know, Gary typically has the other shoulder too.
I usually have a shot that is looking at this monitor and a little bit of side of my head.
Right.
But those cameras are still in, they haven't been unpacked from coming back from Tapper.
Honestly, what I would do if I were you is I'd take, what's the ceiling above you?
The ceiling above me?
Yeah.
It's garage ceiling. It's white white drywall, and there's some lights and some wires up there for the Ethernet or whatever.
I want you to. I have a guy I know of.
Did, you know a guy?
I know lots of guys, but a guy I know of did what you're trying to do to turn out a very pro show with the exact cameras you're doing, and it turned out excellently.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So your required reading for tonight is to check out a podcast on the internet. It's called The Gizwiz. G-I-Z-W-I-Z.
Yeah, I know. That's Laporte's show.
No, it's not.
It used to be.
Dick DiBartolo, right?
Yeah,
or no?
Dick DiBartolo and Chad Johnson's show.
Did you catch when I was the guest?
What?
Did you catch the episode where I was the guest?
On the Gizwiz?
Yeah.
When the heck were you on the Gizwiz?
Very early in the Ham Radio Now pantheon. It was one of the first 20 episodes.
Was that where you were still a ham radio? What's that other show?
ARVN.
You were that's where.
Oh, when a ham nation. No.
When you were still on Bob's show. Or no,
no, okay. No, it was after. But just a little bit. I just started Ham Radio Now.
Got it.
Anyways, Chad Johnson has 4C920 set up for what you're trying to do, and he does it very well.
Okay.
So if you look at the first episode, which he did that, and you'll have to go through the archives, he uses OBS and he talks through it. I want you to watch that.
Okay.
So he's using OBS.
Right.
And he's making it work.
And he's making very good money doing it. And it looks very good.
Cool.
Let me take that back. It looks as good as it gets with $35 webcams.
No, they're like $70.
$70 webcams.
Yeah. But you can get them on sale. You can get them on sale So this is the first one? That's not the first one.
It's time for the Gizwiz with Mad's Maddest Writer, Dick DiBartolo. This is episode 1640, recorded on Thursday, September 14th, 2017. Great expectations.
Let me see if I can find the episode number. One second. To the old studio I go.
So I want to go back a few.
Running through the house.
What?
I want
to
go
run,
back a
Marty,
few.
Run.
The old studio. I think there's still some resurrections of the old studio. For some work, voice tracking I was doing. But as you can see, I might have put the camera on.
How far back am I going?
Let's switch.
So you're saying that this is the new studio. You got to find the shows from the old studio.
No. Stand by one second.
No. Boy, they're on like 1,600 episodes.
They used to do it as a daily show, Dick DiBartolo and Leo Laporte.
Right. I remember that.
It wasn't daily.
It was the weekly daily Gizwiz. They did it daily.
They might have started daily.
But Leo didn't do the daily. It was just Dick.
Gary,
right?
Acknowledge that I'm right.
You're right. You're the young ham of the year. Anything you say is right.
Obviously, I'm right. Okay, episode 1517.
I'll write that down because there's no way I'll remember. 1517. You're getting closer. No, you went too far, Gary.
Oh, it's called Independence Day.
Only
if you
one. No, he hit it. Wow, that was awesome. I think it went way too far. No, it didn't click. 1517.
I think it's like 2 minutes into the show.
Hey, well, you're there,
it's
Gary.
It's time for the Gizwiz with Mad's Maddest Writer, Dick DiBartolo. This is episode 1517, recorded Thursday, May 7th.
Going in about 2 minutes.
Yeah, that's about right.
You know, if you're just tuning in, you know, last week at this exact time, Leo and I did the last show, which was Gizwiz 1516, and we're continuing with the numbering. So this is Gizwiz 1517.
And, so what am I looking for, Marty?
If you
just
subscribe,
be patient for a second.
Shows, two camera shot.
And,
I got it.
We plan on continuing this. We're doing it through Patreon. Begging for money from time to time.
Yeah.
And
click the pig.
And you are now in a whole new city.
I'm in a whole new city. Okay. This is a whole new studio.
Okay, so pause this. I don't want to hear him talk for a minute.
3 days building this out.
Okay, so I thought about doing this. I don't know. You can't see me, Marty, but Gary can, or maybe Gary can. But like, I thought about doing this with the monitor behind me, next to where Arvin sits. I would have to camera out wider, but I'm not sure I want to stand in front of the audience.
So I personally prefer, like, let me switch the camera around. It's in shambles now because this is a studio that's no longer in use. Let's see. Switch. So I personally, camera switch. Yeah, okay, there's perspective. I like standing while I talk because it gives me more energy. And I have a mic way up here.
Got it.
Talk to the people. And I also think it makes for better video because you seem engaged. But some people don't have the energy for that.
No, I could do it.
That sound you're hearing in the background is 14265, the Saturn net. Just kind of waiting for them to make some noise. They've probably moved to 40 meters, so I'll turn that off.
Well, this is no longer a ham radio show, Gary.
This is about making a ham radio show.
This is technical production with Marty Sullivan.
And remember, hi Facebook, thanks for being there.
Oop, yeah. Wait, let me.
I hope you know. Honestly,
there you. You're on camera now.
To some people. But yeah, I don't know. If I were you, I'd do a wide shot, a close up. Kind of over the head looking at the monitor shop and like a gadget shop. There's four cameras right. for you.
Okay.
So what are we impressed with on this, or is that just a shot that you think was cool?
If you listen to the video for a minute, he explains what he's doing, which is what you're trying to do.
There are so many really cool things that I learned and that are new to me to make this studio happen. Things that I bet on that I hoped that I could do. That turns out most of those things I could do. We are, instead of kind of the professional style cameras we had at Twit, we're running this all off of very small, high quality webcams.
Mostly Logitechs?
Logitech C920s.
Okay.
And we're using, they have a new stand that I'm using.
By the way, this shot is coming from a Logitech C920. And this shot is coming from a Logitech C920.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I'm on.
And this shot is coming from a $4,000 right. Sony professional camera.
So the
an antique now, by the way.
Those are still good cameras. For live, they're great, as long as you don't care about tapes.
Yeah, it's a tape camera. And I looked into getting...
Are you just firewiring, passing that through?
I take the HDMI out, convert it to something called SDI, serial digital, and that goes into the Wirecast system. So apparently OBS works.
Yep.
OBS works to a point.
What I think I'm not going to ever be able to do is he's going to be able to do OBS and record it here. I won't be able to Facebook Live, I don't think.
Do you not have bandwidth?
Because I don't know in OBS how to port it out to Facebook.
Can I do a demo for you?
Yeah.
This is rather impromptu. So you can see. Why isn't my camera? Is it the right orientation? Okay. There we
yes.
go. So if you go into OBS, let's see. Let me call you from this computer. Can I call back from this computer so I can share my screen?
Yeah. You want me to hang up on you?
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
This stuff is complex. There's no
question. Yeah, absolutely. Oh, you know, there's been a couple times where I've been sitting here thinking, am I ever going to be able to ever do this? and then I'll have a couple breakthroughs. Like once I figured out scenes and how to get the scenes going and the second camera, I was like, oh, I can do this. But then there were some setbacks. Their virtual camera thing had me going for about 2 days thinking, maybe I'm not going to be able to do this.
But you found it.
But I did find it what was weird is it didn't show up in Skype, and then the other day while I was in there, when I put the second camera on the system again, then all of a sudden, then now there's an OBS camera. I'm like, oh, well, it wasn't there before, but it is there now. Woohoo!
Well, Wirecast went for about a year without being able to send its virtual camera to Skype because Microsoft changed Skype.
Right.
And it stopped accepting the type of video that Wirecast sends as a virtual camera. Wirecast released an update that fixed it, but for the longest time they were saying Microsoft would have to fix it.
Okay.
And I don't know if I was the instrumental one in this. I had done some research and posted on a Skype forum, and somebody came back and gave me some basic information, and I passed that along to the Wirecast guys, and then a couple months later it started working. They're not being very transparent about what they did. And now Skype's got a new version, a Windows 10 version, and Wirecast doesn't work with that as a virtual camera. So I'm hoping that they don't deprecate the old version of Skype until Wirecast figures out what they've got to do.
So what's coming to you? Does it look focused? It looks soft from here.
It looks a little soft, and you don't have autofocus on because you're.
Yeah, well, and let's see. Maybe I can get back into Skype. Every time I try to go into Skype to look at the tools, it tells me, "Oh, you're doing something goofy with that OBS camera and the webcam settings aren't." No bueno. But I guess if I change it to I can't select the Logitech cameras now because the Logitech cameras say, no, some other application has control.
Right. Why OBS does.
But that's okay because that means I got at least the first part of the problem that I thought was insurmountable, which is how do I get OBS back to you via Skype? Now I've got that, so you can see my lower thirds and all that coming through, which was a part I wasn't sure I'd be able to do. Yep. And I guess from a Facebook, Marty will show us Facebook.
Yeah, I forgot. My Skype doesn't ring on this end because I don't want people trying to call during the show.
Marty's dialing and dialing.
So I've got a watch.
How many times did you call Marty?
Yeah, how many times?
Hello, Marty.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, how many times did you try to call me that I didn't answer?
I've been in the middle. Everything's been taken apart up here, so it took me a second to put it back together. Am I coming out of the right place audio-wise?
Yes, you're on your PR40.
I bypassed the processing and whatnot, so it probably sounds pretty crappy.
You're kind of low.
I'm pretty hot now, I assume.
No, about right.
All right, we'll go with that. So, I want to make sure you're not going to see any. You know what? If you see a stream key, that's.
So, is Phasing Line going to become a television show?
Well, I'm going to television for some work stuff I'm doing.
Work stuff? Marty, you're 15.
I was going to say, Marty.
I'm not going to elaborate a ton on what that looks like on the air, just because I'm not really going to.
When's your birthday? When are you 16?
I'll be 16 in a couple weeks.
In October? Discovered we're both October babies, aren't we?
I'm not in October. Anyways, on with the tutorial. So, scene two. I just want to put video on the screen so you can see.
Yeah. Okay. You're doing the camera. Okay.
This is like a very. This is not a computer I normally use for video, so it's pretty. Not. Whatever.
Okay, so this is OBS we're looking at.
This is an old version of OBS, I believe.
Okay.
It's probably. Oh, you know why? Because I need to turn off my camera in Skype. Duh.
Right.
One second. Skype. One second.
He's hung up.
He's going to dial back with the camera off.
Hello?
Hi, Marty.
We hear you?
Yeah, I hear you. I'm not trying to call you. I'm just trying to... Yeah.
You should automatically come back into this session.
Right. Skype is just being weird to me. One second.
Gary, how many computers are going? Is it just the one computer running everything, or do you have more than one?
On this end, there's one computer that is in here. Okay. There's three monitors, one that's got mostly Wirecast, but it's also got the web browser in it. Two is big monitor that's just for display. Well, it's also, you know, when I switch you guys on, it's looking at that monitor.
Right.
And then three, this one is my line output monitor. It's what I see is what's going out, what's being recorded and what's going out.
How big is the one in the middle?
22, 30 something.
Oh, okay.
So big. It's not that big. Fairly, okay, then it's not 22. It's probably 32.
Okay. There yeah, 30, 32 is what I got. What I got in the. Okay, so let's see. So you got that, and you deactivate or activate. Okay. So you're there. Okay.
Something's real weird about my camera, but all right. So you know, there's normally a picture of me there, but something's being real weird.
Yeah.
So there's a real zoomed in shot of me. So here, you know, just so you can see something.
Right.
You know, there's two things. I just pulled two random.
The one on the right is the live one. The one on the left one is the one you're getting.
And
ready.
I have them on set up on my keyboard, so I can cut and whatnot and transition and play out media and whatnot.
Yep.
So if you want to live stream out of OBS, you go to settings and then stream.
Right.
And then you can pick a streaming service.
Right.
Facebook.
Oh, it's on there. Okay.
Facebook Live.
Oh, well.
And then you just grab your stream key from Facebook and drop it in there.
Okay. Duh.
You drop what in there?
You have to get a key.
An RMTP key.
So you got to set that up outside of OBS.
Yeah, you just grab that from Facebook.
Yeah, because in
Facebook Live.
In Wirecast, you sign into your Facebook group inside Wirecast.
Right, you just log into Facebook in Wirecast.
Yeah, and then it sets it up.
Okay, so originally what I was telling Gary was that I didn't think, you know, I could stream to YouTube or I could just record local and upload it later. And now that makes even more sense. I stream to Facebook and then after I'm done, then I upload to YouTube later on and I can fix all my goofs.
I mean, you're just perfect already. So
I can do this. Well, I'm not perfect, but I'm getting there. But I think I can make this work. I now just have to rebuild the studio, which I'm more than happy to do. To see if my lights are tall enough.
So, Marty, Jerry Ellsworth is a big fan of yours.
I'm a big fan of hers.
Did you watch the show?
I did not watch the show yet.
You know what? Before you watch the show, go to QRZ in the forums.
I read the mean stuff in the forums, and it pissed me off.
Yeah.
It's rather disgusting, and I won't spend too much time addressing it here because all this is doing is feeding the trolls.
Right. Well, and I think Gary,
I like giving them red meat.
I kind of think you're right, Gary. I think probably either you have to decide you are doing this intentionally to bait them, and
which is something Gary would do.
They are. I'm with you there. Or it really does bother you, and maybe you want to stop. But I have a feeling you're doing this intentionally because...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it spins them all up. Jerry, in the interview, says that she likes to be a little trolly, which actually kind of surprised me that her one response... Well, first of all, I'm... thank you, Jerry, for... She's probably not watching by this time. Thank
Jerry
you.
And Amy were both awesome.
Thank you for coming on the show. I really appreciate that. She's done a bunch of the other shows. She's been... I now understand she's been on Tom's show. She's been on Amateur Logic. I'm sure she'll be on Phasing Line at some point, Marty.
And she's willing. The door's always open.
Yep. The thing that impressed me the most is after we did the show and things came up on Facebook and on YouTube and on QRZ is that she is engaged there. She's taken the time to see where the show came up and where people are making comments.
And needless to say, she's a very busy, famous, successful person that has far better things to do. Oh.
Oops.
There we go.
Yeah.
So I can do. You'll see something. There you go. Okay.
There you go. All right. Well, this has been awesome.
What?
This has been awesome.
That she's so talented, famous, and
Jerry,
has a lot better things to do. It's impressive.
Yeah.
So what I'm trying to do is figure out is what happened to my shot of David.
Am I not sending? I think I'm still sending.
Was your shot of David coming from me? Oh.
There he is. Now
I'm here somewhere.
He had disappeared from my Skype. But
here I am.
Now he's back.
I'm back.
Now, this is very weird.
All three of us are switching video.
No, I could turn mine off. I might kill my Skype feed.
You're sending it, though.
Yeah, you know
yeah,
what?
I am.
Your OBS is your source of...
Oh, that's right.
Skype.
Yeah, it'll top me out.
So there you are. But when I switch to Marty, you go more away than I'm used to.
Let me do one thing here. I can full screen project.
Can I make this smaller? There we go.
There we go.
Ta-da.
So my shot should be David now.
It is.
Yes.
Somewhat
about seven rows of Skype icons.
Well, we stack them up every time we go back and forth. You know?
Right. And now I realize why you have the lower third where you have the lower third, and it's to mostly cover up the Skype buttons.
Oh yeah.
Well,
I could put a lower third on you, but then it would just be too dynamic.
Right.
If you leave the Skype frame alone, the Skype buttons go away after a while.
Yeah.
And I also blow up the Skype picture just a little bit to get rid of some stuff.
Crop factor when I do this for real is big.
Yeah, or in some shots I actually do a gray mat and just show some pictures in the middle of a gray field.
Got it. All right, well, I'm learning tons.
All right, I guess that's kind of the Celluloid guide to the live streaming.
Yeah, so I had the lighting lesson. Now I got the live streaming. I got the studio set up.
You can skip film school.
I could skip film school. Now I have to figure out if I'm going to stand up. I got to get a taller table. Well, I guess I got the workbenches behind
me. If you want to stand up, just put X's on the floor of where you set everything up and then stand there.
You're going to limit the length of your show as to how long you can stay on your feet.
Oh, I can stand for a long time.
Which would probably be a good thing, Gary, to be honest.
Hey, come on. I lost 20 pounds, and I don't know if you can see it, Marty, because the microphone's in the way, but I have way less neck than I had before.
You look good.
That's what I've been doing.
I've not lost 20 pounds.
For the last 6 weeks, I've been
boot camping.
If you lost
20 pounds, you'd be gone, Marty.
No, I would not. I wish.
Yeah, five in the morning, 3 days a week, and then another day, and I'm just eating chicken and cauliflower.
This is for you, Marty. Oops.
What?
Jimmy John's.
I don't do it's that, not, John.
Well, you're always giving me grief about my Subway cups.
Well, but Subway.
Well,
I
like Subway just as much as you do. So.
But I was at Jimmy John's today.
That's Irvin in the background.
You're not sending any picture now.
I know.
What happened to your picture? There's Marty's picture.
Am I sending picture?
You are.
Oh, your Arvin makes noise. I'm jealous.
Wow.
And he's also very pink.
He's really pink. He almost looks red. No, it's pink.
Yeah, he's actually more red.
Or the color's bad.
Okay, that's enough.
That's like telling the guys in the QRZ forum to stop it.
He's 15 years old, everybody. Remember that.
Yes.
Almost 16, though.
I want to know what my problem is, then. Are we still alive?
As far as I know.
You know what I haven't done, which I usually do, is I usually watch the,
All right.
the comments in the Facebook room.
Everybody's. I've scared everybody away, which, you know, is probably...
No, that's all right. You're doing good, Marty. So how does it feel now to be the young ham of the year? Do they give you you got all these responsibilities to do and
no.
Yeah, ribbon cutting ceremonies and
handshaking, yes.
Do you get a cool plaque?
I do. You know what? I can show you that.
A lot of comments here.
Kurt and
we need camera control units. Cats are cool.
Yeah, so the guy, there you go. Frame. That's cool. All right.
Oh, and he killed him. Eh. if I turn off the key light, I'll be able to see it, but you also won't be able to see it.
No, I can see it. We can totally see it. Oh, no, that's worse. It was better before.
And now, this is why lighting's the thing.
Well, no, that's the thing. Now the monitor, now you can see the monitor off of it. But before, actually, you didn't have the monitor reflection. Go back about a foot.
There you go.
Hey, so the guy on Gizwid had a little secondary keyboard thing for switching.
Yeah, those things are like $15-$20. You can find
like US, they're like USB, right?
Yeah. Okay. They're real handy.
There you go.
What
was it?
Okay. He has a special one that he bought from some fancy company, but anything will do.
Yeah, right. That's what I figured.
Yeah, I use
USB assignable.
If you can see that, it's just a numeric keypad, and I've got a little appendage program that lets this switch shots for me.
Is that just wireless?
Yeah, it's actually on 27 megahertz.
Wow. All right.
And, you know, Gary only uses that because it doesn't actually get on the air, so it doesn't matter if it's, you know, RF.
Right. I have to give my CB call sign when I use it. So I'll push the zero button, and it'll switch to the microcam. And I'll push the 4 button, and it'll switch to you guys.
Right, and that's kind of what I did on the numeric keypad here, but I could see the value of getting that extra thing.
Yeah. But this looks cool. I probably ought to check Genovation.
So what CP Chad does 24. For his setup is he actually has what I would recommend is he has the cameras coming down from stanchions on the ceiling that can fold up and fold down.
Uh-huh.
But they're real handy because you get a nice, stable, clean shot, and wire is better managed.
$80. But, well, here's the problem. Okay, it's a possible problem. It may not be a problem. So I'm going to go live with the camera here. I don't know if you can see Marty. Oh, no, you're on the wrong camera. Hold on.
Switch the shot.
How did I get?
It's not Gary's fault.
No, this is me. How did I get over to that camera? Here we go. So, again, here's the awesome lighting you had me do. Above me is the garage door opener and the tracks. So I'm limited on how much stuff I can hang from the ceiling because when the garage door opens, it basically opens to where you see the Cat 5 wiring going across the roof up to my parents' house.
Mm-hmm. Keep in mind that Chad is doing this as a job.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
But
yeah,
the investment is not that big.
Yeah. Well, I have, you know, like I have speaker stands. I got this ladder. I'll figure something out.
Yeah. You can get, if you ever have a speaker stand, you can get for about $5 online a speaker thread to a quarter 20 for a camera. And they work real great.
Okay.
So basically a tripod thread. You can also get, you know, C stands and whatnot.
You can get the tripod thread at Home Depot for, you know, 39 cents a nut. You just have to get the right thread size.
Quarter 20.
Yeah.
Well, you know, he's not making that much more than I am.
He's doing two grand a month
per episode, and he does how many episodes a week?
I think one or two. So that's somewhere between
He's doing per episode. I'm doing per month, but I'm at.
But this is only one of his many shows he does.
Oh, okay. Is he still doing the Minecraft thing?
Yeah, which is far bigger. I think he has like over 1 million subs on YouTube.
Well, then I had. There's hope because somebody reached out. One of my other ham radio friends wants me to help him do a Boy Scout show, or at least like a couple of serious things. So we'll see.
Suddenly,
if
you're becoming
out.
the television expert.
We'll see. The problem is,
I'm playing with these, and I'll have a full technical review once I get more comfortable with them. But I'm playing with these Blackmagic cameras, and so far I'm very happy. I have the Micro Studio camera, which I think is the perfect webcam. Very expensive webcam, but a great webcam. And it would be terrible for all. It's not the right camera for either of you, but so far I'm very happy with it. In my quest to get to a 4K studio.
All right. Well, so the one thing that I do, $1,600, no way.
Yeah.
The one thing that I'm gonna need to do, and I sent the wrong thing again, is get a portable camera, one that I can take out in the field.
So you want like a either like a Sony Handycam.
Like a Sony, yeah.
None of those are cheap though. Those that'll topple your budget. And then,
well, actually, I think I can make it work. For that part, because they're gonna sponsor doing the show because there's value in there for that. And they have pockets.
They have pockets. Yeah, I really like the. I've been eyeing, or actually, the TV station I work at. We use all real cheap. They're only like $1,200 now. JVC pocket cams with dual wireless rigs on the top, and they work real nice. But cheap is relative. By the time you put it all together, it's probably like a $2,000 rig.
Can you do like XLR mics into those? Or are you
We have two. Okay. You know, two dual. We use the JVC HY70s, I believe that they are. Let's see. JVC HMHGY70s, 170s, and they're like $1,200 or $1,300 cameras. HM170s, yeah, they're $1,295 at B&H. The Catch 20, they're kind of the crossover between like a, they're prosumer.
That's 1080p or is it 4K?
That's 1080p. That can shoot 4K at 30 frames or 24 if you're a cine guy. 422, 1080p, up to 60, dual SD card slots. It's really, they sell a nicer version for closer to $2,000 that has SDI out and whatnot. It's more of an, that's the setup for like more of an ENG rig, but this has dual, you know, dual XLR ends, and we love them.
Cool.
The only thing it doesn't have, and this is more of a making expensive things cheap, is on the lens you have a focus ring and a zoom ring, but then there's a separate iris. You don't have the traditional three rings, like you do on bigger cameras.
We lost Gary.
I'm working on something.
Gary's working on something. It's going to be the big reveal.
I'm of the opinion, Gary will contradict me, that there's no reason to buy any real camera today that is less than 4K, because it makes sense to work towards a 4K workflow.
Oh, absolutely. I agree with you.
Right. On my garage budget,
We'll get the Boy Scouts to spend some money.
I will get that. Yes, exactly.
Yeah. And you got to get, you know, another $1,000 on Electrosonics wireless microphones, and you can be a pro.
Woo-hoo.
There we go. I finally got the shot pack I was looking for.
Yeah, that I was like wondering, what happened to the shot with all of us in there? Here we are, and Arvin's hiding. Where's Arvin? There he is.
I'm sorry I don't have lights on him. I probably look very blue in this shot, but I apologize. Anything else?
I think I've on overload.
Yeah. Those are great cameras, though. You have somebody else to spend money with.
So where is this shot?
And I think I can actually share. Yeah, let me switch back to this shot.
It's not that.
What are you looking at?
Oh, okay, there. It's that shot. You guys want to look at a little ham radio stuff?
Yeah.
This is what I was. These are the toys I use at work. A real night.
Yeah, but I'm probably not going to do an upgrade to 4K because...
you have to buy four cameras, it adds up.
Yeah, they're too expensive. And for me...
And the other thing you have to think about is then you need a 4K production workflow.
Yeah, well, and I could do some of that, but I'm not sure I could do all of it. I stopped at Xenia.
Oh, I saw the mud.
Oh, yeah, I saw the mud, the mud tracks.
Yeah, so this is...
Wait, well, you got to promote it up because only you can see it. Only I can't see it because I see Marty's camera. There you go.
Well, you should be able to switch to my Skype feed and put that full frame.
Oh, you're right. There you go. Okay.
Okay, this is in the flea market around the edge of the track.
Mm-hmm.
And you can see the ghost of Invention Bast. close-up.
How was how is the DCC, by the way?
It was really good. The thing about the DCC is that if you...
The content probably means nothing to you.
Well, if it's... Some of them do, and some of them don't, and some of them, you know, more or less. It's if you... If a subject matter of any given talk appeals to you, then that's a great talk. And if it doesn't, then, you know, you don't really care. But
you fall asleep at all?
I almost didn't, because I was sitting up on that stool, and if I'd have fallen asleep, I would have fallen off, and I would have fallen off into my camera, and that would have been a problem.
Curious question for you. What were you using for that big, it looked like you had like a 10 or 12-inch monitor on your main shot? What sort of monitor was that?
It is made by a company called G-Chic, G-E-C-H-I-C. I'll go get it. Hang on. It's not too far away. You guys,
let me guess.
Amuse the audience.
It's CCC stuff.
I've seen those on the B&H site.
So you're going to do studio at home?
Yeah, for work stuff more.
But, for work stuff? Work stuff. Marty, you're 15. Is that after school job?
Yeah, with the TV station and whatnot.
Awesome.
And I'm doing a little bit of voice tracking and radio stuff from.
And how about Sterling? You guys gonna do another show this month? I shouldn't talk because
we did one less than 2 weeks ago, and we have another one that'll come out on Monday. It's awesome. Already been recorded. Those are like the $200 the poor man's monitor, right?
It was probably a little more than $200.
How's the color?
It's good enough.
And what is that? That plugs in HDMI?
Yeah.
So it's just
a monitor. Doesn't have any other smarts to it.
It's not a recorder.
Not a recorder. And
yeah, so controls. Brightness, yeah.
Do you trust its color, or is it really consumer? Is it more consumer?
Oh, it's all consumer, but I calibrate it somewhat. Come on, camera, find your focus. There we go. And the IO on the other side is there's what looks like USB is power. Then there's HDMI.
Like mini HDMI.
Micro HDMI.
Micro, yeah.
I don't know what these two are. VGA. But they're the micro connectors. The only two I use are power and HDMI. And you can't see any of that because it won't stay in camera. It won't stay in focus. Come on.
You got to move it. You're too close, I think.
It'll focus.
There you go. Oh, was there a second? There's a DP, HDMI, DP. There it goes. It did it.
It's
VGA.
Trying, but.
It's hunting.
Yeah.
I think you're too high. There you go.
Yeah,
right there.
I'll give it more to focus on.
So if this
plane
was not a gearhead show, it officially is.
Okay, now you've got enough to focus on, you stupid camera. There you go.
There you go, right there. That's the money shot. Headphones, USB, HDMI, DP, and VGA.
Don't know what DP is.
Yeah, I don't either. Marty?
Yeah?
What does DP mean?
The connector?
Yeah.
The DP connector.
It's DP.
It's a HDMI, it's a display port.
Oh, really?
Display port.
There you go.
Yeah, it's probably some rendition of mini display port.
I should have known that.
Yep.
Oh, you know what? Guys, I want to introduce you to... No, I don't want to.
You guys are already bored with the...
Can I introduce a new ham to TV?
Wait, is there more? Oh, yeah, you got a relative there? Bring her on.
Okay, a new ham doesn't want to come on TV.
It's your mom?
Is
it mom or sister?
Mother.
Yay.
But
come on.
Casey
won,
I don't know.
Come on, mom.
They're nagging you. Come into the shot.
I heard that earlier. I heard that on, whose show was that on?
There she is.
Hi, mom.
He's saying hi.
Hello.
He says hi.
Embarrass him.
KC1, I don't know, is the phonetics. IDK.
Perfect. That's great.
And My sister is KC1IDH, independent determined ham.
Cool.
Yeah.
So this is what the grass looks like where nobody parked at Hamvention. This field they didn't use for parking, or they didn't use it much.
And that's what it looks like when you parked on it.
Yeah, this one was absolutely just a deep trenches of mud.
And it's pretty well ruined.
And here's the soccer fields where they're playing, but you can still see the tracks where the aisles were. And it's probably not impeding the soccer stuff.
But it did some real damage.
A little bit more, yeah.
That's a shame.
I don't know what the locals think about it.
Locals are already pretty pissed at Hamvention about trying to get fairground furniture to move out.
To get what?
Fairground furniture to move out. You see that article?
No.
The fairgrounds didn't want to review. The fairgrounds wanted to terminate fairground furniture's lease to use the space. In theory, mostly for Hamvention.
The building that was closed
at Hamvention, and it's because there's a furniture store in there. They kicked them out. They terminated the lease.
Oh, okay.
In theory, so Hamvention could use the space.
So locals didn't like that.
Locals were very pissed. Well within their rights, but very pissed.
Well, are they back now or no?
I don't know. I saw the article. It was posted on Facebook, and there is quite vocal people on each side.
Yeah, there always are.
All right, well, I'll jump out and let you guys do a podcast.
Oh, we're probably almost done.
Yeah, I think I got to go make sure my kids aren't burning down the house because mom's not home.
Well, who's your adult supervision then?
He doesn't have it.
Nobody adult supervises me.
So mostly, there's a lot of kids alone without adult supervision.
Mostly when my wife's out of town, it's kind of Lord of the Flies around here.
One thing we probably should mention.
Emma, you want to come on TV? No.
One thing we probably should mention is that all of my travels happened at the absolute worst time for doing anything in terms of MCOM, because I was gone on as things were happening with Hurricane Irma. Then Irma was pointing toward North Carolina, so I almost didn't go to the DCC, and then it moved west, and I drove through the outer bands of it, just light rain and cloudy skies all the way across Tennessee.
We got our communications van ready to deploy just in case it needed to be. I ran through a full test.
And I started to see who was responding and whatever, and I thought, well, maybe I'll make some calls, and then I thought, you know what, nobody wants to talk to me right now. They're all now busy responding.
Can I interrupt the broadcast for a second?
We now interrupt this program.
We now interrupt this program to bring you some important information. With me in the live shot here is KC1IDH. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Welcome. She can't hear us, right?
No, she can't. And she left.
Yeah.
Bye.
I'm really good at scaring them away.
Nice.
Love older, you, younger.
Mwah.
Nicely so tangled up your phone cord.
Yeah.
This was hers. I stole it because all my stuff is packed up in boxes to move studios.
Mm-hmm. You know, the sad part is they're asking for help in the Keys. And my son, he spent summer at scout camp helping, building trails. He's like, oh, they need us at Seabase, but they're only taking over 21. And I told him too, he couldn't not go to school for 3 weeks to go and help build that up.
It'd be great experience, though.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
We got real ready. The weekend of September 10th or whatever, we set up the E350 truck with the mast on it and tested it just in case it had to go somewhere with other.
It's still May because this can be a while before they're back together. It sort of bothered me that we just heard so very little about what's going on in amateur radio from all of these locations, but it occurs to me that's really pretty typical.
Yeah,
that they do.
There's
stuff.
Been a lot of health, and there's been a lot of traffic, especially from the Caribbean, with Maria in particular.
Yeah, and that's what I was going to say. The last one from who got it yesterday? Puerto Rico.
There's been lots of radio traffic.
That's right. They said that the only contact they had, and that was on national news, NBC or whatever, that they said that they were getting reports out via amateur radio.
Yeah,
that was the only one that
finally they're saying that. Usually, yeah. that is the first thing you hear.
Yeah,
and it took a long time.
Well, I think with Harvey Irma, the Jose, people really bought into this Zello will work for me thing. And I know, yeah. I had some very candid conversations with my family over the phone in Florida, where without cell service and without internet, this Zello thing is nothing. It's VoIP.
Right.
Push to talk VoIP.
Right.
And if you don't understand that, you are writing your own death sentence.
And, well, you know, it's like all the folks using D-Star and DMR with internet connections. You know, I think it's cool. Well, it's fun. But without the internet, it becomes standalone local repeater.
Now, there's people that have like D-Star linked networks where over their own IP backbones and whatnot, but that's not really.
Yeah, and there are some state microwave systems that are doing it, and that is one step better, maybe two steps better. But if we're.
I know, around here we have full duplex microwave links.
Yeah, but if our goal is to be backing those things up, then.
What?
That's not a hell. If our goal is to be backing up those microwave links in case they go down, then we can't be riding on them. So yeah,
that's where old analog systems with RF link, with link radios and whatnot become the best option.
Yeah, and I wonder if the internet is keeping hams from building out RF linking, just because they're taking the path of least resistance, so they're not building out the RF linking.
RF linking is expensive and time consuming.
Well,
VoIP is not expensive or time consuming.
Okay, that's my point. Is it because you've got the easy way? You're not doing the old stuff that hams have done for so long, which is to build extensive RF networks. You got something sort of in between, like the HamWAN down in Tampa and a couple other spots that they've got the.
That's kind of a private intranet, if you will.
Well, yeah, but it's wide area, and so a bunch of repeaters around the area can be on it for their link. And then you can, it might not help if things are as bad as all the territory that are covered by that HamWAN. But
right. So I guess that's kind of close to what we have up here, but this is point-to-point duplex links, not kind of wide area and all be all that.
And you need your linking to get you out to the point where finally it reaches a working internet connection.
Right.
Well, you know, one of the repeater systems out here, the Darn network, and I know they've added a whole bunch of things on, so I'm not 100% up to date with what they have, but I know that there's a lot of the linking on the repeater system, because it's five or six or more sites, is all RF, because that's the disaster amateur radio network, right? And they don't want to rely on the internet, although I think that they're starting to have some of that.
Well, out there you've got linking systems that go east to New Mexico and north to Washington State.
Right.
Yeah.
Cactus system. You know, and
the big one, two big ones that come to mind are the Papa system and also the Fun Machine system out there.
Yeah. Right. And there's the Wind system covers.
And the Wind, that's what I was thinking.
But now is Wind, Wind is internet, isn't
Papa
it?
System.
I think so.
Yeah.
And I'm not Papa, talking about it. Some of the Papa stuff is, I'm a Papa member, and some of the Papa stuff is, but they're starting to go more and more D-Star, and they've had a whole bunch of DMR and Brandmeister stuff, so everybody can talk to everybody, but the analog is like almost all dead.
I'm not helping, the worst
enemy of emergency response is DMR, with its code plugs, computer programming, and headaches of all.
Well, yes and no, because all the commercial systems that do all of your public safety, they start with that.
Right.
And so if you've got your radio set up for it and it's been programmed for what you need,
then
it's more
reliable.
So what
happens to the ham who rolls into the new area and has no clue how to make a code plug, because all his friends make his code plugs, which he doesn't know what's in it.
It's even worse than that, because I will tell you, I very rarely, every once in a while, you have somebody come to like an Aries meeting and they'll have a Baofeng and somebody to help them program it. And I just know that they're not trying. But like the guys
Baofeng,
that I know.
I will say Baofengs are not that hard to program.
I No, they're not. But the guys that can't program those, right? And you just know they're not trying, or maybe they're not technically astute. But now more and more, the guys that I know that can program their own analog radios are coming with the DMR radios, saying, "I can't figure this out." And I think you're right, Mark. They just have no idea, because it's so the whole. And I don't know anything about DNR, and I probably won't for a while. That whole code plug thing is just baffling to some people. And people who I think
are smart. It's also the idea of, especially with the Motorola radios and whatnot, when one guy's making the code plugs, he kind of has control. Because he can say, you can talk to you, but not to you. And he can also say, I can stun kill these radios. And the guy who's installing the code plug on their radio will have no idea. And he can also say, well, I can listen to whatever is on this radio. Because all that power is then vested in this one guy where everybody else is now clueless. And it creates a really bad power dynamic. And it also just sets everything up for failure, in my opinion.
I guess that can work that way. I've been making code plugs since, you know, a couple of days after I got a DMR radio. But then, you know, I'm good at that sort of stuff. If I were to come into an emergency situation with my DMR radio, and that's what they were using, there should be a physical contact point that I roll up to and say, here's the port to my DMR radio, give me your code plug. Because we all want to be using the same code plug so that everybody...
Right, but what I'm saying is that doesn't always exist, and you don't always have that luxury.
It should.
You're going to have problems, too, because every radio has a different... You know, you're going to have the TYT, and they're going to have the Motorola, and somebody else is going to have the
Hytera.
Yeah, exactly. But they're not all cross.
Yeah, there's maybe a dozen that they would have to have prepared. And, in fact, they should send it to me before I go.
Mm-hmm. There's not always that time and luxury. And I think that's dangerous to count on. The fact that I can pull up my, you know, my ICOM handy talkie and dial in whatever I need on the fly. I think is very key. And I feel like from being responsive and ready and prepared, I think DMR with code plugs and all and lack of FPP fails miserably.
Today, yes. Now, whether the ham radio systems, first of all, no one that I know of has adopted DMR as their emergency local or regional system. And that's part of the reason why.
I've seen it up here, and I think this hits the point home, which I make all the time, and frankly, people disagree with, is that DMR, just like P25, just like IDIS, just like NXDN, just like all them things, are commercial modes adapted to amateur radio. And when you take something that's designed where they don't want control, where they don't want FPP, and you try front panel programming, and you try and push it to somewhere where you do, you run into problems. That's where, you know, simple analog and, you know, D-Star, which is designed for amateur radio, works real well.
Well, and DMR works for public service because the guys who are pushing the pickle don't have to do anything other than turn the thing on, and there's a bunch of tech somewhere in a room somewhere that gets it set up and program it and tests it out and everything else.
I think that can exist in amateur radio for MCOM when it's when it becomes appropriate. Marty, there are all day, 8-hour classes for people to learn how to use D-Star. The guys in Georgia, they've been running them for years.
Some of that too.
Yeah, there is a big learning curve for most hams.
And I think there's a bigger learning curve for DMR.
Yes, I agree. Because I picked up
talk groups and who can talk to who and time slots and
part of the problem
CDMA.
Part of the problem there, I think, is that we do a really terrible job of explaining it. I've watched several programs where people tried to teach people how to do DMR programming, and they don't seem to grasp the big picture, at least not the big picture that I get. So it's time for me to make my DMR show.
So
there you go. Teach me, Gary. Which radio? I'll get a radio and we'll...
Well, the only radio to get today is a TYT MD380.
The 380. Okay.
Yeah, unless you're in an area which has VHF DMR. Which maybe your area does.
Like we do in Boston.
Yeah. No, the 380 is the ones that the guys get here. The guys get here get the Kinect Systems radios.
The handhelds?
Yeah. Most of the people up here, I think, they mostly use Moto.
The problem with Motorola is that you need license for software unless you've got it cracked or jeeped or have somebody do your programming work.
But
for
it
you.
Makes for a far better radio.
It makes for far a better somewhat audio. Better radio.
I don't personally use DMR, so it's hard for me to speak to that. But for my side-to-side comparisons, the audio quality between a Moto or a Hytera and China, day and night.
I listen to a lot of DMR, and I listen to people with Motorola radios and Chinese radios, and I don't hear much difference.
Now, yeah, that's what I tell.
Now, I'm only listening on a Chinese radio. Maybe if I was listening on a Motorola radio.
Yeah. Or a Hytera or whatever the... Yeah. Right. I don't think Kenwood does DMR yet, but Harris does a... I think Herrick's EDAX and now DMR and whatnot. But.
I predict that sometime in the next year or two, we will have fully amateur radioized DMR radios.
We shall see. Until then, front panel, I just don't think it's feasible. Yeah.
Well, it's too big a market for people to ignore right now. They could sell a lot of radios if they made hamish radios.
Well, I know the RF Finder guys make those smartphone DMR no code plug radios or whatever the heck they market them.
Yeah.
And I played with one a couple weeks ago and I was not impressed.
It's a totally different paradigm for a radio we're not used to. It's R Finder, by the way. R Finder is how they pronounce
RF
it.
RF Finder. What did I say?
Well, everybody said, a lot of people say RF Finder, but there's no two F's. It's R Finder.
I think
it's RF Einder.
RF Finder.
Well, it's RF Einder, but it's pronounced R Finder.
And with that, I think we should probably wrap. And I gotta.
Can I show one more geeky?
Oh yeah.
Let's see. There's one. This is like getting very periphery here. But
by the way, the reason I said the MD380 is the radio to get is because of the price. Get your toehold is an $80 radio, and then work your way up. Uh-huh. Or wait until the hamish radios are available.
80 bucks is all right. I was thinking they were like 100 and a half.
Not anymore.
Woohoo.
So let me share my screen back, and let me show the best price tech of 2017 that was very expensive 5 years ago. This is back to video production with Marty Soloway. Let me just see the whole series here. So the company Zoom is very well known. For their mid-grade prosumer audio recording devices, among other things.
The handheld. It's good.
What?
Handheld.
Yeah, poor man's sound devices. And they recently released this product they called the LiveTrack L12. And what this is it's a recorder that's also a multi-channel USB I/O. So in layman's terms, all 8 microphone channels are recordable channels in Audition or Pro Tools independently. And you can get the masters and the submixes and all that stuff, and it's digital EQ and processing built in. It's also a recorder, and it can record multi-track. It's only $600. I think it's 12 I-12O, so you can do multi-track audio in and out. Pull an audio source out of the computer onto a fader. Lots of real cool stuff, and it's in a full multi-track recorder, and it's only $600. $599.99.
And it has USB in and out.
Yep. Every single channel is a separate USB, separate track, and it blew my mind.
Show the back shot.
The back shot. Do. So you got power, DC in.
USB in, USB out. Okay.
Now those independent 12 is on one USB.
Right, on the one.
SD card,
on the one channel.
Your sample rate. So you can record to an SD card. Let's see. It's a very good value.
Cool.
You got the EQ for each channel and compression for each channel and what's recorded to what. You have combo jacks at the top, as you can see.
What does that combo jack do?
So that's an XLR and a quarter inch in one.
Okay, so you can do a line balanced line or level unbalanced or mic level. Line level.
Or in the first two or the first four, also high Z. So
oh, I see. Okay.
But the kind of the what this kind of is a competitor to is the, let's go back to B&H. Let's see.
I like B&H. But most of my cameras do them.
Baruch Hashem photo video is the Jewish chef. It's owned by a lot of very religious Jews, which is the cool part for me.
And they are closed on every Jewish holiday.
Yes. And today is Rosh Hashanah, so they are closed. I was in temple all day. But the...
is it a happy Rosh Hashanah thing? Is that one of those happy holidays that we wish you?
No.
So the Mackie Onyx, let's see, is kind of the expensive version of this that was a thing 10 years ago. And do they even still sell it? But let's see. Yeah, so it's a, they sell the same thing, but a little bit less powerful for the order of $1,500. This is a terrific value. And from what,
it
from
is,
what
it,
I've
it
heard,
is if it holds up.
And a few broadcast friends I talked to have been using it for remotes, and they say the preamps are Midas quality. You have individual metering on each channel, which is something very nice.
Oh, yeah.
Which is terrific, actually. You have returns from the computer. You can see over here. You can set the fader mode and whatnot and presets and scenes. You can have this. You can have presets for different recording things and... apparently, the preamps, it's broadcast quality is what I was told.
So Ham Radio Now should have one of those. And we'll get one, assuming that somebody out there in the audience, let me see if I got the right, yes, if someone there out in the audience clicks the pig, if enough people out there in the audience
that's
click
probably
the
in the Ham Radio
well,
Now
that's
budget.
So, and so, Gary, switch back to your mixer.
Which is the Behringer, but...
Or yeah. Your mixer.
This is this is a couple of $100 these days. Maybe I think I bought it at a retail store, so it was more like $300.
Right.
But the faders are getting noisy.
Not to say anything to Gary in particular. Behringer to you listening out there on Facebook. Behringer is kind of the consumer junk brand.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A step above Radio Shack.
It's a big step above Radio Shack.
You only have like three or four, hard to tell from here, but counting. You
four,
don't have them
four mic channels,
four
right?
Four of them, yeah.
Well, it depends on what I'm doing. When I had guests in here, I had all four microphone channels filled up.
Oh, got it.
Skype is coming in on this one. Audio from my PC is on that one. This one is currently empty, and this one is listening to 20 meters, which is probably dead now.
What I'm excited to use this for, I want to get my hands on one, is for recording stuff for where I have multiple cameras. And I can just sync the cameras and press the record button on this and deal with the multi-track in post. This thing is really cool.
Yeah.
That's why I thought I'd show it off. Pads on every channel, separate phantom power for the first four and the second four. It's pretty cool.
So, yeah, again, if it holds up. But
reports from the field I've heard so far say it does hold up.
Well, you got to get to 6-10 years of service. You know, or simulate that many button pushes and fader fades.
I don't know that information, but being Zoom is typically decent quality. I'd say it's not great stuff.
That all depends on the quality of the components they put into it.
Right. But I'm saying as a brand, their reputation is decent prosumer equipment.
But to make something with that much stuff in it and sell it for $600, the components.
Just for the uninformed, $600 is a steal if this actually works.
Right. Mm-hmm. But you can't spend a lot on components and build something like that. So the components are going to be iffy.
Or they're just good at making it cheap.
Well, that means that their labor and all the other costs are real cheap. And I mean, they'll build it in China at sweatshop labor. So.
Well, all of these are built in China, Gary.
Yeah.
Yeah, nowadays.
Yep. Yeah. You know, you've had your West Coast bull session title on the whole time, right, David? You can see that.
I know.
Okay.
I know. I'm sorry.
You just want to.
No, I didn't.
You don't know how to turn it off.
The one thing that, that wins me over is, in this price class, this is the only piece of gear on the market, I think, that has individual channel metering, which is huge for me.
Take it.
Being able to meter each channel individually without pulling the remix meter.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Distracted. Yeah.
That's useful if you're kind of wondering what you're getting and you being able to make some decisions before you put things on online.
Right.
On
the and app. It also gives you the capability to go back and post and, you know, mute somebody's mic or EQ a specific person without messing with everybody else.
Yeah. Wirecast, it depends if, or Premiere Pro. I'm not sure how it would bring in that many tracks. It can have that many tracks.
Audition and Premiere can do it.
Yeah, it should.
Yep.
Yeah. It makes your post work far more complicated.
Right, but you can also pull it into Audition and mix down to stereo if you just want that.
We lost
you can record stereo too.
David pushed the wrong button and he went away. He should be back.
Does that mean did back. I
Yeah.
I hit
You
that
went,
was
you went so away.
I didn't touch anything. Something must have hiccuped in the house.
Yeah, sure.
But
okay.
This is tempting for me.
Yeah. So you got another show planned?
Me?
We got some in the can that you're waiting to put out.
I have one in the can that's going live on Monday. And I'd love to. I'm gonna email Jerry and see if she's willing to come on.
Yeah, I'm sure she will be. I mean, she may be able to tell you her news. I've been scouring the web to see if anything's been released yet. I haven't seen it. I haven't looked in a few hours.
What is the news on?
Her company, Cast AR.
AR is gone and out, I thought.
Right.
Or is there more to the story that she hasn't released publicly yet?
Yeah, I heard you were embargoed.
And I still am. I'm waiting for them to make their announcement.
Is it a good announcement or a bad announcement?
Depends on what happens.
Are we still on Facebook Live?
Yeah.
You want to stop that?
In a minute. We need to say goodbye. It was fun getting Amy and Jerry to sink into the over and out thing. Jerry said, well, that took a long time. It's a waste of bandwidth. But it wasn't. It was fun.
All right, so I think we should end this.
Clearly, David. Well, David, are you back long enough for us to say over and out?
You just said it.
This is not going to appear on YouTube, I guess.
No.
Oh
no.
So maybe I'll go make a quick YouTube live or something that says go to Facebook to see the show. You don't have to have a Facebook account to see it. You'd have to have an account and be a part of the group to make comments.
So is Jerry still doing Cast AR full time or no?
Well, Cast AR was shut down.
I remember when they laid off all 70 employees or whatever.
Right, but she's still there and Amy is still there and maybe a handful of people are still there.
Is Jerry still there?
Yeah, mentioned something.
Not Jerry. What's the name of the guy who she founded it with?
Ooh, Brian maybe. I don't remember. I don't know, I've read it, but I'm not retaining the guy. And she had mentioned something about moving out of the offices and stuff, so I think they had to, you know, vacate the premises and things like that.
Rick Johnson.
Okay, yeah. So, you know, the question is, will something Phoenix-like rise out of the ashes of Cast AR one way or another? And she was hoping to have something that she could announce this week, but I haven't seen it yet. So why are you coming and going like the ghost of Christmas past?
I remember seeing that they officially shut down in June.
Yeah. Yeah. And she's got a lot of story behind that, but I can't talk about it. I feel like Marty Selloway right now. I know something I can't talk about.
That's true.
Although Marty always talks about it.
What, I say I can't talk about it and then I talk about it anyways?
Yeah. Well, yeah. You are my ham radio gossip connection. And you won't necessarily talk about it on shows.
Oh, no.
So.
Can you even hear me?
What was it? I was talking to a friend the other day. I was talking to a friend of mine the other day, and I won't talk about what we talked about because he made me sign a form. but I asked him, so what are you doing it for? The first thing he says is, I won't tell you anything. You talk too much. Sign this NDA, and then we'll talk. I guess yep. I yap a lot.
Well, like I say, you know people and things, and nobody tells me anything, but you do. He's gone again.
All right.
What's going on there, David?
I don't know. Something happened. I heard what sounded like a brownout, but everything stayed on. And
I guess he needs a UPS.
He needs some of. You need some of these. Let's see if I can get them in the shop. You need some of these, boy.
Over and out.
Well, we each...
No, I'm on a desktop that's...
You know I'm a ham when I have 35 amps of 12-volt power within arm's reach.
That is good. All right, so... So, let's see. I can do... Come on, there we go. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. Oh, Ham Radio Now. Ham Radio Now is brought to you by you. If you enjoy the programs, get something out of them. HamRadioNow.tv. Even for only the Facebook Live shows. I'm Gary Pierce, I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. Marty, I don't think I have a title available for you. You're not Jeff Wittick. You're not Cindy Pierce. You're not Frank Hughes. And... You are a member of the Begging for Funding Foundation, though. I believe you're a charter member. And so trying to get back into the program
but
is David
Goldenberg. I'll say it anyways. I'm Marty Soloway, KC1CWF, phasinglinepodcast.com. Click the donate button. Give me some love.
Okay. And I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG.
Over. Somebody say and. David's too late.
And out.
Well, no, you just say and when David gets back, he'll be able to say out. Say out, David. Say out.
Out. Scott, it's